Fishin Affliction. Hello.
Rise and shine. It's Fishin Affliction time. For those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids. It's time for the fishing show. Me and old Rusty's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, and don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Man, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here.
Rise and shine. It's Fishin' Affliction time. Thanks for tuning in again this morning. Hello, this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction here at the HD Studios. This morning, Brother Dan Firmanick and pro staffer Doug Markham are heading over to Old Hickory Lake looking for some walleye and other species as they take the Triton train to Trailin' and Trollin' Town. Hey, be sure to check out our new online store. It's on our website, fishinaffliction.com. And don't forget our featured Team Fishin' Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week is coming up at the end of the show. So sit back, relax, and enjoy Trailin' and Trollin' on Old Hickory Lake on Fishin' Affliction TV.
Well, folks, there's nothing like an Old Hickory Lake sunrise. And this is what Doug and I got to witness that morning time. Just unbelievable beauty that God creates. And I was sure looking forward to spending some time in the boat with Mr. Doug Markham, doing a little fishing and enjoying the adventures of the day. And folks, so many of us are familiar with Doug's outstanding work that he's done throughout the years on television and his long-running radio show Outdoors with Doug Markham that continues to be a major influence and resource for us outdoorsmen here in Middle Tennessee. And Doug had some great information that was going to help us to try to catch some fish on the upper end of Old Hickory Lake. Well, Doug, if there's a prettier day to fish, I don't know that I've witnessed it.
Well, you know, Dan, summertime in Tennessee is tough, but if you get out with the morning sun, it's very comfortable. In fact, kind of got a little chilly coming up river. It's going to be a nice day. I hope we get out here and beat the heat a little bit. And
what is our target today?
You know what? We're going to try something a little different. I know you and the big dog like to catch largemouth bass, and I do too. And I think before the day's over, we'll target them, but we're going to start early on walleye. I know that the Cumberland River, because TWRA stocks a lot of walleye in this river, has a good population. And we are below Cordell Hull Dam, a good ways below it, but we got water temperatures in the 70s out on the river. And that's good. That's very good for all kinds of fish. And we're going to see if we can catch a walleye. I've heard they're biting down here, never been in this area. And really in the early phases of learning how to catch walleye after all these years of fishing, I just really enjoy trying to figure out how they bite or what they do. And maybe with your help today, we'll catch one or two.
I bet you what, maybe we'll get them to cooperate today.
I hope we get them to cooperate. We're having fun anyway. We're sitting there messing with this Lawrence unit.
Boy, you can spend all day doing it, can't you?
It's fun. I'm telling you what, it really adds a dimension to fishing that just makes it fun. Even if you don't catch fish, it's just amazing seeing what's down there that you can't catch.
Well, we are trying to target a good-sized walleye today, and we'll see what else we can get into. We're going to do it with a little trolling method and maybe some crankbaits or something like that, Doug?
We are. We got swim baits. We got crankbaits to troll with. There's all kinds of ways to catch a walleye, and you know, you can do live bait, night crawler rigs and all that, but we're going to do crankbaits, and we'll probably throw some swim baits, and we'll just see what happens.
Well, with the help of our trusty Lowrance HDS units from BBG Marine, we started looking and locating a bunch of bait fish. And it wasn't long before Doug had the first fish on.
Here's one coming in. He is kind of odd looking. I think it's because I've been dragging him a while on this bait and didn't know it.
I tell you what, though.
There you go. They're going to hang out in similar water.
Now, Doug, real quick, there's a lot of folks that are not going to know the difference
So why you got this one? Well, tell us about
the big diver. Of course, you can see the model in, on a sauger, and you see the teeth on a sauger. But the big thing will be on the tail. You'll see white down here on a walleye. There's no white on the sauger. It'll be a white tip, and that's your biggest giveaway. Hopefully, we'll get one today, and because they're hard to tell apart otherwise. But that white tip down here is the giveaway. This is a sauger about 14 inches. It's below the size legal size limit in Tennessee, and
which has to be 15?
15 inches on a sauger, 16 inches on a walleye. Oh,
really?
So you need to know about that white tip, because that's how you identify them. And anyway, this is a good sign. So we pulled through a spot, just started pulling, and I think I probably had him over a little. Damn, we're pulling some pretty heavy bait. So when he's that size, you don't always feel them real well. But they're beautiful fish, great eating, fun to catch to me.
Now that is beautiful. What a beautiful fish.
We'll toss them back.
Yeah, we've been working on a Fishin' Affliction fish stretcher.
Mm-hmm.
And
bring it out. Get it out now. Get it out now.
Well, folks, the prototype for the fish stretcher is still in the works, but I haven't perfected it yet. So this sauger's got to go back there to the wilds of Old Hickory Lake. And speaking of in the wilds, folks, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, while the Inniskillet gal and I were fishing the other day, these two mallard ducks got really close to the boat, and Miss Vic was able to get some great pictures. And while she was snapping away, I was busy fishing. And folks, look what I caught. Now, this is a pumpkin seed. And folks, these are some of the most beautiful fish in the waters of Tennessee. They don't grow big, but they're a lot of fun. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com, and be sure to like us on Facebook and upload us a bunch of those great pictures, and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild, your pictures in the wild.
You know, some of the first spinnerbaits that I ever threw growing up in Michigan had painted blades on them. The new Strike King Tour Grade painted blade spinnerbaits, they have that supernatural look. I mean, when you look at the sexy shad color going through the water, it looks like a school of sexy shad.
It's not just a white blade. It's not just a chartreuse blade. It's a, you know, it's got the natural bait fish look.
When we say Tour Grade, when you pull it out of the package, it's ready to go. It's got every possible component at its very top-notch best.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Tennessee boat operators born after January 1, 1989 must show a Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency issued card as proof of successful completion of a nationally approved boater education exam administered by the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
Non-resident boat operators in the state of Tennessee who fall within the age requirement must show proof of successful passage of the National Association of Boating Law Administrators approved boater education course.
Safe boating is no accident. Take a safe boating course.
The Tournament Trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM Smyrna Ready Mix. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
This is Tim Cramper back with the Natural Bass Angles. We just finished up our tournament here on Percy Priest Lake. I'm standing here with the winner, Mr. Dave Drummond, once again for the third time this year, had 7.93 pounds. So Dave, once again, what was the winning strategy?
That's flipping. My fish came flipping, caught on the bluff, on the jig.
On the jig?
Yeah.
That was a good string. It was enough to win today. It was a slow day, but folks, join us next time, October 8th and 9th. We'll have our two-day fish off at Kentucky and Lake Barkley. Thanks.
Congratulations to all those who participated, and thanks to SRM for sponsoring the Tournament Trail. And now, folks, back to Fishin' Affliction. Folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by Clark Marine down in Franklin, Tennessee. They offer the very best of Ranger boats, Triton boats, Sea Arcs, Express Aluminum boats, Sea Rays, and Veranda Pontoon boats. And folks, they have been serving you with excellence for over 30 years. For all your boating needs, be sure to see Stuart and the award-winning team of Clark Marine, and check out their incredible interactive website at clarkmarine.com down in Franklin, Tennessee.
just turned kind of sideways. Get my foot over here. Here's one coming in.
Welcome back to Fish and Affliction. And right before the break, Affliction Pro staffer Doug Markham caught this sauger while trolling a Strike King Series 5 crankbait. Now, the fish was just a little too small to keep, and since we haven't yet made our Fish and Affliction fish stretcher, we had to put him back. But while we were in that area, we noticed that the conditions looked really good to pick up a Strike King flipping tube and a shaky head to see if we could put a bass or two in the boat.
It's not a walleye, but that's not a bad looking bass right there.
That's a good looking fish.
That is a good looking fish, isn't it?
When did you catch him on?
I caught him on the Strike King. That's that 4-inch, 4.5-inch flipping tube. And we're up here looking for some walleye. And we are. But we stopped for just a minute. We found a nice little place to do a little flipping and pitching. That's a beautiful fish.
And you suggested it. You said, let's flip right here.
You know, it's these little bends in the river. That's such a healthy fish. You know, Doug, you were saying, let me put this fish back. You were saying about... It's going to be about two and a half, almost three, maybe. Having the water temperature where we're at is just totally different than if you're familiar with fishing the lower end near the dam. And, you know, you can't approach it the same. We are seeing bait everywhere. And these fish are just, they're everywhere. But, you know, there's so much to eat out here. And they just don't eat 24 hours a day. You know, it's like snacking. They can snack and snack right in their house right here. So... that one snacked on a Strike King 4.5-inch too. So, but we are going back to walleye fishing here in just a minute.
Oh, you catch bass if you want to. They don't hurt my feelings.
Especially
now.
Like that, huh?
Yeah.
Doug, shake your head fish.
Was Dan fishing it the way you told me? Got a little bass.
I tell you what, isn't that fun?
Fishing it on that Strike King you can't tear up for him.
Yeah, you ain't kidding. That 3X material will stretch to 5 country miles.
It will. He's a little bass, but he's I love him all. And he knocked the fool out of it.
Now, right off the...
coming down the bank right here where you suggested us throw, steep bank with some wood going down, and as soon as I tossed it in, that little guy hit.
Well, I'll say this. He liked that bait better than he liked mine because I already threw there already.
Yeah, well, maybe it's all about the worm right now.
That's great. That's
it
awesome.
Was fun. He hit it real well.
Well, after releasing that largemouth, it was time to get back to trolling for those monster walleye and saugers. But the next one we caught, folks, well, he wasn't a monster, but he sure thought he was.
Well, Doug, on the end of the Strike King 5XD right there is a future movie star fish of Fish and Affliction. Getting closer to what we kind of came out to target, isn't it?
It is. There's a lot of those, and there's TWRA is going to decide through the years, I think, whether they stay more with stocking this fish, which is a sauger, or going more with walleye, and I hope we get a big walleye. But nonetheless, this is a sauger, and the agency stocks them in this river, in the Cumberland River, by the thousands. Problem is, a lot of them, it seems we get a lot of complaints from anglers that they don't always get very big. I caught one the other day, 19 inches.
Oh, wow.
Which is a good fish, but I caught a bunch of them this size, a whole lot more of them that size.
Sure.
And I love them. But in Tennessee, they have to be 15 inches to keep if you want to eat them.
Sure.
And a walleye has to be 16. But they're fun.
So, Doug, this fish came out of the hatchery, then?
More than likely, that's a hatchery fish. They still do reproduce.
A little bit. Let me get them in the water.
Okay.
And let me ask you this, then. Are they released at that size or half that size? Or?
No, they're a lot smaller than that.
Are they? Okay.
Yeah, you play the number games. You release them when they're fingerlings, and you might put 200,000 in, and you expect 10 or 20% to make it.
Well, we're targeting trying to get us a good walleye today, but that bite came in on the pause. So let's see what happens.
We'll see. I love catching them.
Well, I tell you what, that is fun. They're beautiful too.
Beautiful. Good job.
Uh-oh. He is like not only the Strike King bait, but the Doug Markham bait also. Look at there. Well, that's just part of the trolling, folks. You know? I'm going to go right back there, Doug. Come on with me.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Well, all right, buddy, you get half credit.
I don't think so. Half credit for being in the way.
That is SWAT. That's on a Strike King Series 5. Not an XD, a Series 5. And what we've got out here is we actually have a main channel hump on the river. And, Doug, it's loaded. It is loaded with fish.
Yeah, and, Dan, you never know when you're trolling. You might say you want to catch walleye or sauger or whatever. But the beauty of trolling is that if they like bait fish, you can catch them.
And you know, the other thing too, folks, on a day like today, what it's, you know, it's going to be a triple digit day. It's a good way to pass the time.
It really is.
You can actually do a...
Isn't this nifty little thing you got over my head?
Yeah, that is kind of cool. The mantis, we'll have to show that a little bit later, yeah. But it is a cool, cool thing. Doug, I'm going to have to do a little surgery so we can let this guy grow up.
Okay.
Well, folks, let me show you the mantis, and here it is next to Doug. It's a sun umbrella designed to protect you from the harmful rays of the sun, and it's absolutely one of the greatest things that I've ever had in the boat to help protect me from those harmful rays. It's fully adjustable both up and down and left and right, and it collapses on itself for easy storage. It's a great thing to have in a boat, and I believe they still make them, but I'm not 100% sure as the website was not working when I tried to go and visit it right before this show. So if you get the chance, do a Google search for mantis umbrellas and see what you find. And I'll tell you what, if they still make them, they are a great product for you to get.
Well, Doug, it's not a walleye, but I'll tell you what happened. We got up to the front of this island, and we saw some activity, some bait fish just going crazy up here in the shallows. Couldn't help but pick up the Strike King 4.5-inch flipping tube, make a couple casts, and caught another nice little largemouth. We are on a bunch of bait fish up here, and we are just running through them with our baits, seeing if we can get bit, and also prepared to do a little bit of flipping and pitching just in case the occasion arises, as it did right then. Got to make one more pitch anyway.
Fishing that willow grass.
Yeah, not neat stuff. You know, one of the neat things with this tube too, Doug, I'll show you. You know, we get a lot of this little baby shad that are a little shad up here that are splashing around, and this tube can actually make that same sound. You check it out, you might be able to hear it. Now that sounds exactly like a fleeing shad. What will happen is you can take that bait, throw it next to something, let it splash, and just let it sit. And if there's a bass that's on the prowl, he's conditioned to come to that splash, because that's where he knows to go and feed. It's hard to believe that they'll come from 3 or 4 foot away.
It's a good tip.
It is a neat tip. I don't think many people fish the tube, but, you know, just from a flipping standpoint anymore, but as much. But it's a, I sure have caught a lot of fish. It catches a lot of fish. And it'll catch nice fish. All fish are nice, but. There he is. There he is. There you go. And that is an example of that right there, though. Now, a lot of folks would think that might be the same one.
It is the same one.
Kind of cool, huh?
It is.
Well, folks, I don't know if that's the same one I just caught a minute ago, but I do know one thing. It sure is a lot of fun to catch them. And I'm sure enjoying my time in the boat with Mr. Doug Markham, catching those fish up there in the upper parts of Old Hickory Lake. And in a moment, we'll be back with some more fishing action. But right now, let's hear from the voice of Fishing Affliction, Mr. Matthew Gillen, as he tells us about the weekly team Fishing Affliction special from Clark Marine.
All right, here is a spectacular 2006 Triton 220 LTS bay boat with a Mercury 225 DTS Optimax engine, Lowrance X26 GPS in console, Motor Guide 82, and comes with SmartCraft gauges. This awesome bay boat won't last long, so call now for special pricing or cruise on in and see Stuart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales, Paytonsville Road, exit 61 off I-65, Franklin, Tennessee. And now let's go see what Miss Vic's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and since Dan and Doug are out there trolling for those big walleye, I wanted to give you a great recipe for crispy baked walleye. And now for the ingredients. You will need eggs, breadcrumbs, instant potato flakes, Parmesan cheese, seasoning salt, and walleye fillets. And folks, this recipe also works well for any of your favorite fish fillets. First, beat a couple of eggs with about a tablespoon of water. Now let's make our breading mixture by mixing together our potato flakes. Now let's add our breadcrumbs. Next, our Parmesan cheese and about a tablespoon of seasoning salt. And get that all mixed together. Dip your walleye fillet in the egg mixture
Now coat it really well with a breading mixture and then place it into a greased baking dish. Now bake this at 450 for 15 to 20 minutes. After these walleye fillets finish cooking, add your favorite side dishes and you're ready for a delicious dinner. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com and be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe as well as all of my other In the Skillets. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
Kevin, what are you doing here?
Oh, I'm just filling in for Billy.
I need 660 shad crankbaits in the Series 5 model.
We're out.
You're not out. You got all kinds of them right there.
We're out.
Kevin, I need six.
Have a lollipop.
I do not want a lollipop.
Have a lollipop.
Do you have it in sexy shad color?
Hello everyone. Hey, it's time to go deer hunting. If you're an archery hunter, this is what you've been waiting on for almost a year now. Again, archery season is going to begin September the 24th. Make sure you look at the hunting guide to see what the bag limit is in your part of the state, or if you're coming to Tennessee to hunt deer. We have a long hunting season in Tennessee for deer, and I'll be talking about that more in the weeks ahead because the gun season is going to be a little different this year. See you next week on Fishing Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishing Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Harris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge Battery Charging Systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Hey there, Doug, and they're strong, aren't they?
They are the river fish.
They are. Look at that. What a chunky, chunky fish. Oh, my goodness. You know what? I'm not even sure if he'd measure, but is he chubby or what? It's a beautiful fish.
It's a nice fish.
4.5-inch Strike King flipping tube, and Doug's throwing the Strike King finesse worm. And we're on just a little bit of pattern. We're on a bluff here in the river, and that fish is actually nice and cool. We have a temperature, a surface temperature of 85.2. If you go on down the lake about 15 miles or so, in some areas you're actually in the 90s. I actually saw 92-degree water temperature yesterday. What a beautiful fish, huh, Doug?
He's gorgeous.
So pretty. Well, once again, folks, you know, we came here to do a little walleye fishing, and we're still going to do that. The conditions are changing as the day is going on, and we're making sure that we had other opportunities to fish for other species of fish, and that's what we're doing. So we're just fishing. That's great to do.
Dan, how you put that thing on there?
Well, it's chewed up already. See that, Doug, right there? Mm-hmm. You know, it's chewed up pretty good, but the thing about a tube is that, you know, there's a lot of material here, plastic, that's not messed up. So all you got to do is get a good grip in one portion of it, which is really the bottom where the hook comes out, not where it goes in. Mm-hmm. So I just end up rotating the same tube over and over and over until finally I just literally run out of good places to do it. And I use a little something called a clamshell for a weight. This is a clampable weight. Just comes in, you can buy them in different sizes. This one here is not in terms of weight, and it's in terms of what they refer to as size. This is a 4, and I don't even know what the weight is. I'm going to guess it's a little less than 1/8 of an ounce, and that helps that bait. It just has that slow descent, and it's something interesting that happens with these 4.5-inch striking flipping tubes is that when you pitch it, it traps air in the body, and then when it hits the water, the weight then noses the front of the bait down. And then it lets that air out. So for a second there, there's a pause on top of the water with your bait. Now that's if your tube doesn't have a bunch of, you know, holes as this one has. But with that said, it's a really neat thing. But you'll actually throw your bait out there. It'll sit for a second. The air will come out the other side and it'll go back down.
Cool.
Just a neat thing. Just a little bit of a pause.
Pretty good.
Hey, what you got, my friend?
You got a little bass. You've been showing me how to use that. tube all day, and you fishing. This is another thing that makes fishing fun. Okay, it's what a part of what, not that they caught a fish, but that Dan was going down the river and he sees this cool opening, and he's going to show you. And we come back here. It's almost like a run in a creek. And first cast, I hung something and didn't catch it, and then I just threw back in there and caught something. But we're going to show it to you. It's little discoveries like this that make it so fun.
Amazing, though. Just amazing. Look at the flow, people.
Dan, you dug a good one now.
This is just a couple minutes later. But I tell you what, Doug. You know what, too? Well, interesting. That happened on this particular fish is I missed him the first time, or I think it was him. And it seems like they're on that tube a little bit better than they are in that the zero. That's a dandy fish right there.
It's a nice fish.
A very nice fish. But that tube, that 4.5-inch striking flipping tube, he wanted that more than you put it, that bait right where he was. But, you know, that's an interesting thing too, folks. A lot of times, let me get a good picture of that. A lot of times when you are pitching and flipping, we kind of get tuned into our the baits that we prefer. And when I flip and pitch, I always have a couple things on the deck just in case one of them doesn't pick up a fish. You have to believe in the area that you fish that there's fish, number one, and we've been fishing an area that we just really think there's fish in here. So if we don't get a bite on a certain bait, it's always good to have a backup of something else to try, and that's how you learn what the fish are going to like. Sometimes we throw, or most of the times I'd say we throw the fish the baits that we think the fish ought to hit, as opposed to what the fish really want. So,
well, folks, I hope you're enjoying spending time with Mr. Doug Markham as much as I am. And folks, next week we're going to do it again. And although Doug and I got a little sidetracked catching those largemouths, we didn't forget what we came for, and that was those big old hickory walleye. So make sure you tune into Fishin' Affliction TV next week when you hear Mr. Doug Markham say,
Doug, I got a net. I got a net.
Oh, there he is.
Is that what you're looking for?
That's what we're looking for.
Is that what you're looking for, my friend?
He came on. You found him, brother.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is Chris Baker. And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt the Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
People don't know, but these things will talk to you.
I love Fishin' Affliction. Yes, I do.
And he's saying,
don't throw them striking baits around me no more.